UK Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Now we'll have an automation introduction. For this, we have some slides, we'll go through them. Yep. Here, this is a definition of automation testing. Automation testing is automating the manual testing process currently in use. It means whatever we do as part of manual testing, we'll try to automate it. Okay, say if I manually I am entering a username, I am entering a password, we will try to automate those steps. Whatever we follow as part of manual testing, we will try to automate those steps. Okay, that particular process is called as automation testing. And here, test automation is a development activity, not a testing activity. It means, yes, automation testing is a kind of a development activity, because here we are going to write some set of programs to test the application. Okay, our main activity is something like we are going to write the automation scripts, automation programs. The intention of the program is to test the application. Okay, it's a kind of a development activity, not a testing activity, and generally associated with software tools. Automation testing means it associates with some set of tools like QTP, Selenium. Okay, here we are going to basically understand the Selenium. And moreover, let me give an overview here. Throughout our class, we are basically going to understand the automation concept. Then we will try to understand how that automation concept will be implemented in Selenium. Okay, if you learn like that, what will happen? In future, if you want to learn any other new tool, say if you want to learn QTP or if you want to learn Test Partner, if you want to learn any other automation tool, it will be easy for you to follow. Okay. So, what I'm saying here, first we will understand the automation concept, then we'll understand how that automation concept will be implemented here in Selenium. So, in future, it will be very helpful for you to learn any other tools in automation testing. Okay. We'll go further here. And why automation is required. This basically explains why we should go for automation. Okay. See here, because if you want to reduce testing time, if you go for automation, testing time, the time that we spent on the QA, quality assurance, as part of quality assurance activities, it is going to be reduced. So, which is directly proportional to QA cost. Because if you are spending less time, means it is directly proportional to cost, right? Eliminates the manual testing errors means, say for example, he found a bug. Say you are performing, say you are doing a manual testing. He found a bug. While logging the bug, you will commit a mistake, right? As we are human beings, we will commit a mistake. Say we perfectly found a bug, but while logging the defect, we may commit the mistake because we are human beings. Those kind of manual testing errors, okay, those kind of errors will be avoided here. It avoids, because it's automation testing, so it will be very alert. Okay, for performing the tedious tasks. Tedious means here boring task, a repetitive task. Okay, say for example, you have a banking application a monthly statement has to be validated for 1,000 users. it's going to be a very tedious, a boring task, right? Because you have to perform the same task for 1,000 users, okay? And moreover, it is a banking application. You have to be very careful while validating a banking application or healthcare applications. You have to make sure that everything is correct, okay? So here, for performing the monthly statement for 1,000 customers is a kind of a repetitive and a tedious task. Okay, those kind of tasks can be, it is preferable to automate here. Okay, proof of adequate testing. It means, say in general, as I was saying, say we have a manual test case. Say we have a banking with monthly statement, say 1,000 customers. Say we have 1,000 customers. Say we have this scenario. Say in general, if I ask you to do it manually, what is the general approach? Any guesses? So if I ask you to do it manually, what generally organizations perform? My question is, say it's a banking application, monthly statement, okay, and say we have 1,000 customers, okay. So here, I want to validate this particular monthly statement functionality. Okay, see if it is manually, how this can be performed. Any guesses? Yeah, fine. Generally, in terms of manual testing, what we will do randomly. Yes, that's correct, Sujata. Yeah, basically we randomly choose some 5 to 10 customers, okay, and we will retrieve their statements and validate. If all the for these 5 to 10 customers, if the functionality is working fine, we will conclude that this monthly statement is correct. But it is not a, basically it's not a complete testing, right? Here basically we are randomly choosing 5 to 10 customers out of these 1,000 customers, and for these 5 to 10 customers, if the application is working perfectly, I think we can conclude that this is working fine. This is how generally a manual testing follows. But it is not going to give 100% confidence, right? Because it's more of a banking application, and if you test like this, it is not going to give a 100% confidence in the application. But if you can write an automation script for this, okay, you can execute for 1,000 customers and say in future after 3 months, say we have 2,000 customers, still our automation script support even these 2,000 customers, okay. So here I'm saying proof of adequate testing means, so by using this automation testing, we can execute the script against all the customers monthly statement. It's just an example, okay? So which increases the confidence on the application, okay? Consistent test procedures ensures the process repeatability and resource independence. It means, say for example, as I was saying, this functionality, like randomly we have tested with 5 to 10 customers, okay? And this 5 to 10 customers itself, okay, say for first customer, say as a human being, say for the first customer, I have followed some approach, say to validate the first customer's monthly statement. Okay, to test the first customer's monthly statement, I might have followed some approach. Say approach one, okay. It is something like say, I hope everyone knows manual testing basics. Like say we have used boundary value analysis to test first customer and monthly statement. Okay. Say for the second customer, testing the second customer monthly statement, probably we may follow approach to say something called equivalence partitioning as part of manual testing. Okay. The other case, say we have tested this 5 to 10 customers, say during the release 1.0, we have tested this 5 to 10 customers monthly statement using say this approach one. The other way, I'm saying the other way. Okay, say during release 2.0, say the manual tester might have followed the other method. I mean to say here, there is a probability that the approach may be different for different customers or different scenarios, different cases, or different releases. There is a probability that might happen in manual testing. Okay, but that is not going to be in automation testing. Once you build your script, say you have built your script, say we have built automation script using say boundary value analysis. Okay. So say we have built automation script using this. Okay, in release 1.0. From release 2.0 or release 30, we are going to use same script. It means we are making use of the, say this automation script is built on boundary value analysis, right? So we are using consistent test procedure, one thing. The other thing is, even say today I have developed this script, okay, say tomorrow I move to another team or another project, so you may come into the picture and you may work on it. It's a kind of a resource independence, okay. When you see the script, basically you will understand. And moreover, once you build a script, there won't be any kind of changes much. If you have changes, it's a kind of a maintenance. Okay. So that is what actually this point is explaining. Okay. Consistent test procedures ensures process repeatability. It means, say you have built an automation script using a boundary value analysis. That concept, that approach is going to be used in all your releases. It's a kind of a consistent test procedure. And resource independence. So today one person might have developed the script and tomorrow someone else come into the picture and that person can also work on it. Okay. So these are the points where we generally go for automation. Now let me move on. When to automate. This slide actually talks when we should go for automation. Okay. Tests that will run many times. If you have any test cases that need to be run for many times, it's something like just now we were discussing the same functionality. Functionality is same, like monthly statement is same, but we wanted to execute that functionality for 1,000 customers. It's a kind of a repetitive task. Tests that will run with the different sets of data, again it is of the same kind. Say for example, you have a registration application. Say you have a Gmail application and the Gmail, say you are doing a registration. Okay. For that registration, say I want to do a registration with 500 customers, 500 accounts. Okay. That is going to be same functionality but with different sets of data. Okay. Tests that need to be run for every build of the application. We call it as like a regression testing. I hope everyone knows regression testing. What is meant by regression testing? Can you post your guesses in the chat box? What is meant by regression testing? Any guesses? Yeah, regression testing basically, we got a new functionality. Okay, because of the new functionality, the existing functionality should not get effect. Okay, we are going to make sure that the existing functionality did not get disturbed because of the new functionality. Okay, everyone try to understand this statement. We are going to make sure that the existing functionality did not get disturbed because of the new functionality. That type of testing is called as a regression testing. Okay. So here for each build or each release, why we are going to do it? Because in each build or in each new release, we are going to update our software. We are going to include new features. Say in old version, we might have two features. In the new version, maybe we will have 3 to 4 features. Okay. So for each version, probably we can we will increase the features, and moreover we are going to fix if there are any issues. So we will make sure that because of the new features, the existing features are not getting affected. Okay. So in that case, basically we can go for automation testing. Okay. Just need to be run for every build of the application. Okay. It means if you want to make sure that the existing functionality did not get disturbed, so we can write some set of scripts. Say going forward, if there is any build, if there is any new release, we can simply make use of the automation scripts and will make sure that our application is working properly. Okay. And when the application under manual testing is stable, basically this is a kind of a prerequisite. One of the prerequisite and one of the important question across this automation testing. Okay, actually, I'm showing you slides, right? One of the important point among these slides, when the application under manual testing is stable, it's a kind of a prerequisite for automation testing. Will not basically go for automation testing if the application is not stable. For example, just to make you understand. Say we have a login functionality. Say it's situation 1. Say user has entered a username, enter password, click done. Sign in. Okay. Say for example, in morning, say 7 a.m. we have typed this. Okay. And say user is able to log in. I mean to say user get into a home page. Okay. Say at 8 a.m. again user tried, say it got an error. And say at 9 a.m. again user tried, say it got into unknown page. Say 10 a.m. again user tried, say it getting into some kind of compose email page. Okay. Now see here in situation 2. So this is situation 2. Now say we got error here. So for all the cases, when I try here, I'm getting error here. Now, can you guess what is the situation 1? What is the situation 2? Can you find any difference here and there? Yeah, but it's very simple. Actually, this is a stable application. Okay, this is a stable application. Even though we are getting a okay, let me ask the question like this. Which situation is a stable application here? Situation 1 or situation 2? Yeah, situation 2 is the stable application, because how many times that you tried, it is giving error. Of course, it may give error or it may be anything, but it is consistently giving a single error page only. Okay. But here it is, sometimes it is giving home page, sometimes it is giving error page, sometimes it is giving unknown page. Say here, meanwhile we say we did not touch anything in the code base. I mean to say here, say technically developer did not touch this program, whatever the application might be. Say developer did not touch the application. Okay. Now in this case, this we call it as a not stable application. Okay. If we have any application like this, generally we will not go for automation. Okay. If we have any application like this, probably we can write the scripts, but we cannot execute the scripts. Okay. Of course, even we cannot perform the manual testing, right? That is where this point is talking about. This is a not stable, this is a stable application. I hope everyone is able to understand this example. Right? here we are not sure which page is appearing over here, but here we are sure that for each time, for how many times that we try, it is giving a single page. It might be error page, but of course we have, this is a stable application, and moreover we can say here it has a defect. Okay, now let's move on here. So this point is talking about that when application under manual testing is stable. Okay, if the application is stable, then only generally we will go for automation testing. Okay, and testing products which are very difficult to test manually, it means there will be some scenarios wherein which we cannot test the applications manually. In that case, we will go for automation. Okay, one of the example is load testing. It's a kind of performance testing. Okay, performance testing is one of the good example. We have to go for automation. Basically, we cannot rely manually. Okay, even performance testing is a kind of automation testing. Okay, that is the reason we have kept a point over here. This slide actually talking about when we should go for automation. Okay, now let us move on. This slide is basically talking about when we should not go for automation. Okay, say if we have 1000 test cases, it's not that when we want to go for automation, we are not going to automate all the 1000 test cases. Say, for example, we have 1000, say we have a banking application. Say we have Citibank. Okay, say we have 1000 test cases. Say we want to go for automation. We will not automate all the 1000 test cases. Okay, we are not going to automate all the 1000 test cases. That is what actually this point is talking about. Okay, we are going to filter the 1000 test cases. Okay, based on these points. Say here, if you have any test with unknown results, cannot be automated. Okay, it's actually again talking about the stability. Say here, you know the input, like you are entering username, you are entering the password, and you are clicking on sign in. After you click on sign in, you are not sure after sign in what page it is going to give to us. It's a kind of a unstable, and moreover, if you have a scenario like this, those kind of test cases cannot be automated. The other way, in other simple words, say we have 5 plus 6. Say we know that output is 11. Say if you don't know about that 11, I mean if you don't know what is the output, you are doing some operation. After performing your operation, say if you don't know what is the output, those kind of test cases cannot be automated. Okay, that is what actually this point is talking about. Tests with unknown results cannot be automated. You have performed something, but after you perform, say if you don't know what is going to be the next step, what it is going to do as part of your input operations, those kind of test cases cannot be automated. Okay, so out of this 1000 test cases, you have to see any test cases like this. If you have any test case like that, you are going to remove them, and cannot be used for the functionality of the application which changes frequently. Okay, if the functionality of the application changes very frequently, for that trend also we will not generally prefer to go for automation, because say you have built a script today, and say tomorrow of this suddenly the whole functionality has been changed. In that case, our script are nothing. They are not going to be used much, because today you have built your script based on today's application, and tomorrow the application is going to be changed. There is no much use, right? So if you have any scenario, if you have any application like that, it is not preferable to go for automation. Okay, cannot be used for a project that has few releases. It means, say if you have a application, and that is going to have only some 2 or 3 releases, in that case also it is not preferable to go for automation. Why? Because say you have say for example Facebook, say it has only 3 releases. Are 3 builds, release 1, release 2, release 3. In this case, it is not preferable to go for automation, because say in release 1, say you build some automation scripts. Okay, you are making use of these automation scripts in 2 times only, release 2 and release 3. In general, it is not going to give much helpful because the return on investment, whatever the time that we spent for creating the scripts, are not going to be recovered if we have only few releases. Say for example, say for the manual, here manual testing, and say here automation testing. Say manual testing is taking say 50 hours to test this release one. Okay. See, automation testing maybe probably it may take 80 hours. Why? Because here we have to write the scripts. Basically, it will take longer time than the manual testing for the first time. Okay. And after that, say here in release 2 and release 3, okay. Say here again manual testing probably it may take the same time, but automation scripts maybe say it is going to take 2 hours. It is going to take 2 hours. Okay. So here the total time that we spent here is 150 hours, and whereas here we have spent 84 hours. But however, here if you consider the tool cost and if you consider the extra resources, and moreover I just mentioned in some numbers. Okay. Here I said 50 hours and 80 hours. So if I would have say here, if I change the numbers, these numbers are going to change, right? Say for example, if I say here, say manual testing is taking 35 hours, like this. If I would have mentioned, it is going to be a different number, right? I'm saying just, these are the numbers I have mentioned. So if you have few releases, okay, even these numbers like here, we don't have much savings. Okay, we are taking a lot of risk. After taking a lot of risk, we don't see much savings because we have few releases. In general, if you have few releases, it is not preferable to go for automation because we cannot see the fruit, the advantage of automation. Okay. Say if you have say release 30. If there is any plan for like release 30, in that case you are going to save lot of efforts. Okay. Here it is around if I say release 30 means 35 into 30. Right. It's around 10,000 hours. Okay. Whereas it is going to be very less. Say 80 hours for the scripts plus 60 hours for executing the scripts. So there is a lot of difference because we have took the risk and we would have purchased some tools. Of course in Selenium we are not going to purchase any tool. But if you consider any Q-tip tool like that, you also need to consider the tool cost, right? Resource cost. Okay, those will be nothing over here because here you spend very less time, whereas you are going to spend a lot of time. Okay, so that is what actually this point is talking about. Okay, can I be used for the projects that has few releases because we cannot see much ROI, return on investment. Okay. When the project does not have enough time, say if we have any fixed build project and say the project is asking us to complete the task say in 40 hours, it's a kind of a restricted thing and it is not preferable to go for automation in that case because it may take more than that. And moreover, if you don't have enough time, don't spend time on the automation testing. That is what actually this point is talking about. Okay, by considering these points, and not only these points, there will be some things like sometimes we cannot automate our scenarios. Like for example, there is a printing functionality. Say here, if I want to take the printout of this Word document, okay, say it is going to get in the printer, okay, and after it comes in the printer, I want to make sure that whatever there is in the page and whatever in the document, I want to make sure that both are same. That is that possible using the automation? That is not going to be possible using the automation. Say you have a printing functionality here, you are going to print. And the printout is coming in a paper. Okay, we cannot validate this functionality with that whatever we have in this document. Whether that is presented in the paper or not, we can test it manually, but we cannot make it automate. Okay. There will be some test cases like this. So those test cases are going to be avoided, okay, by considering these points and by considering printing functionality and image capture. Say for while registering into some application, we used to get some dynamic images and sometimes we are getting some messages to our mobile phones so that we can proceed. Those type of test cases, if you have any test cases like that, those test cases cannot be automated, because which requests the third party interference. Okay. Again, I am making this point, like prerequisite for automation testing is application should be stable. Again, I am just mentioning, highlighting this point. And main concern for automation testing is, if this is another point which is very important with respect to automation. Say if you have any question like, say what is the main concern for automation testing means, the identification of the object or field in the application under test. We'll discuss this in detail in coming classes. Okay. Say whatever the tool that you are going to use, say it might be Selenium or it might be some XYZ tool, that tool should have a capability in having a compatibility with the application. Okay. The tool should have a capability to recognize the different objects in the particular application, like say username, password, sign in, okay, different fields in the application. Tool should be able to recognize, should be able to identify different fields in application. Okay, that is the main concern. If you are able to do that, okay, you can automate any application. Say for example, say I have built a tool, say I have built XYZ tool. Okay, say I have developed my own tool. Say if this tool is able to identify each and every field in the application, I can make use of this XYZ tool. I don't need to depend on Selenium, I don't need to depend on Qtip or whatever it might be. I can use my own tool. If my tool has the capability to recognize the application, like different objects in the application, I can make use of my tool itself. Okay. So main concept here under automation testing is, you should be able to identify the application properly by using the tool, whatever the tool that you are using. And this gives what are the tools that are available in the market. Okay, here see here, this is functional testing tool, and here from HP, from IBM, from CG Software. Basically, these are the tools which are paid tools. We have to pay some money. So various tool vendors means you have to pay basically money for these tools. Okay, here we have a WinRunner QTP. I have to update this slide. Now we are calling QTP as EFT. Okay, so these are the different tools for different purpose, like functional testing, performance testing, test management. And this is a tool, like functional, here this is a tool which is for the, these are the open source tools. As part of functional testing, we have Selenium, Wotif, and for performancing, we have JMeter and Bugzilla. Basically, this table is talking about what are the different tools available for different purposes. Okay. Now here we are actually getting into Selenium. Now we actually jumped into Selenium. Whatever we have been discussing, it's a kind of introduction to automation, like what is meant by automation testing, why we should go for automation, when we should go for automation, when we should not go for automation. Okay, those kind of things we have been discussing. Now here, what is Selenium? If Selenium is an automation tool for web-based testing, okay, it means this is a tool for web-based applications, and this is an open source tool. It means we can simply download and we can use it. We don't need to pay any single cent for the tool. Okay. And moreover, say if you have any innovative ideas, even you can extend the tool. You can bring new features to the tool. Okay. That is possible here because it's an open source. You will have the source code of the tool. So if you want to extend, if you want to bring up any new feature to the tool, you can do that over here. Okay. See, in the other case, say if you have any paid tool, like say if you have any QTP or if you have any relational robot, these tools, okay, if you want to have a new feature, you have to contact to the RNA, you have to contact, say in case of QTP, you have to contact to HP saying that it is preferable to have a so-and-so feature so that they can validate it, whether that feature is possible or not, whether that feature is helpful or not. They will validate, and then they will implement that feature in the coming releases. Actually, I have given one of the solution, one of the idea for the HP in quality center. There is a framework called BPT, business process testing. As part of BPT framework in quality center, I gave one of the idea. They have implemented that solution in the recent releases. Fine. Let us move on. Okay. Here, here this is open source tool, and it, I mean to say here, we can simply download and we can use it. And here, the latest version of Selenium is 2.0. Latest version Selenium 2.0 means the current release, whatever the Selenium that currently we have, it is 2.0. We can also call it as a Selenium WebDriver. Okay, we can also call it as a Selenium WebDriver. And this talks about the what are the advantages of Selenium. Here it is an open source tool. Okay, a zero investment. We don't need to spend any money on for this, and it can be customized. This tool can be customized. If you have any innovative features, as I said, you can customize this particular tool. And here it is a multi-browser compatible. It supports Internet Explorer, Firefox, Google Chrome, Opera, and it is also going to support Safari, Netscape. Okay, I did not mention over here. And it supports different operating system, Windows, Linux, Mac, and it is this one, Unix, iOS operating system, Android operating system. I have to update this particular slide. And very much useful for agile model. It means basically Selenium is it's a very good tool for the agile methodology. Okay, nowadays agile methodology is it is getting more demand in the market. Most of the organizations are moving to agile methodology. In this agile methodology, Selenium is very much compatible. Okay, probably I hope everyone has attended the demo. If you remember, in the demo we were discussing about the advantages of Selenium. Right here we understood like cost, multiple browsers, okay, multiple operating system. Here I said choice of language. Yes, apart from this, yes, there are I said Ajax calls or latest web applications. It means if you have any latest web applications, Selenium is preferable to automate any latest trends. In a sense, I mean to say here, in old days, if you remember, if you take any, if you consider Gmail itself, if you remember around 7 to 8 years ago, the Gmail was a kind of a plain HTML application. Now if you open Gmail, it's a kind of, it is having a rich content, right? The look and feel of the Gmail has been changed a lot, okay? Those kind of applications can be automatically, those kind of applications will be easy to automate here using Selenium rather than the other tools. Okay, probably I will show a scenario. Okay, and moreover, apart from this, here the other advantage is in agile methodology. In agile methodology, Selenium is one of the good tools to use it. It has very compatible with agile methodology. Why means in agile methodology, basically the application changes, the application application will be very rapid. Say today we have one kind of application, tomorrow the application shape might changes frequently. Okay, in that agile methodology, Selenium, the way that Selenium we handle here, it's very easy to handle in Selenium. Okay, I said I will show this this one, right? Give a minute. I wanted to show this kind of agile, I'm saying Ajax calls and all, right? Give a minute. Let me log out from my Gmail here. Even nowadays, when we are trying to log into Gmail, there will be an option, do you want to log out, log in as a basic HTML? Say if you have a slower connection, it will give a suggestion saying that do you want to log in, do you want to launch Gmail using a basic HTML? I'm just opening a window here. One minute. Yep, I'm talking with this. Nowadays, the trend has been changing. Okay, now here, for example, here, see here, if you enter something here, it is immediately showing a kind of a feedback here, right? See here, if you enter some value here, immediately it is showing a feedback for it here itself. Okay, if we have these kind of application, it is very easy. We don't need to think much in Selenium. Whereas if you go for any other tool, okay, it is very difficult to automate these kind of scenarios in other tools. But in the Selenium, it's a kind of a regular case. Okay, in a normal way, we can just automate this kind of scenarios in Selenium. But it is not the same case with other tools. Okay, that is what actually I'm talking about. This, okay, Ajax calls and latest web applications are like this. In old days, what will happen? Once you enter the password here, once you click this submit, once you finally click on the submit, it will say that this password is not matching the requirements and all. But now, what it is doing, while entering the password itself, it is giving the feedback, right? Okay. Yep. Here, however, it's here we have some more advantages as we listed earlier, like it can be customized. Okay. It is very much helpful for the agile methodology. Okay. Now this slide is talking about the again differences between Selenium and QTP. Okay. It's basically Selenium supports only web applications, and here if you see here, it supports web applications, Windows, ERP. It almost supports all type of applications. This is the open source. This is a paid tool. This is, we don't have any support here. We have support is available. Not 100% secure. Why I'm saying not 100% secure means it's an open source. There might be a probability that, say, if organization don't maintain any proper firewalls, probably there is a kind of a, we don't have any 100% secure feeling. Basically, it's just a feeling. But here, as these are the tools, which are like pay tools, so it's a kind of 100% secure. And it is highly compatible with the different browsers and different operating system. Here it is very limited. And here language skills are need to be more than QTP. It means, say here, whatever we are going to choose, Java, C#, here basically we need to know a bit more of programming than the QTP. Here in this case, we can manage. In a sense, even we know basics, we can manage. But here that cannot be possible. Here we have to know kind of a more advanced, more than basics. Okay. Here we can customize the tool. Here it is not possible here. Here very much helpful for the agile methodology, but it is not compared. It is not compared that much of Selenium. Okay. However, we already discussed the advantages. We find the differences between QTP and Selenium here itself. Okay. Here, QTP is a very highly paid tool, and as I said, Firefox, it is going to support Firefox, but it is going to support limited versions only. Okay, here it supports Internet Explorer, of course it's QTP supports Internet Explorer, all the versions, and again Google Chrome limited versions, and it is not going to support Opera, Safari, Netscape here in QTP. Okay, and coming to operating system, it can work with only Windows operating system, whereas it is going to support these operating systems. Okay, here we have a different choice of language. So if anyone know here Python, that person make use of Python to develop the automation scripts. But here, whether you know or whether you don't know, we are going to use VBScript here. Okay, so it has advantages and disadvantages. Yeah. Now we have been actually trying to understand here, what is automation testing? Okay, what is the use of automation testing? When we need to automate, I mean, what we need to automate, like we were discussing about why we should go for automation, when we should go for automation, and then we discussed the what is meant by Selenium, and we understood the advantages of Selenium, difference between QTP and Selenium, and of course, disadvantages. Yeah, let me show here. There is no official support for the Selenium, and it supports only web applications. Okay, so here for this web applications, okay, there is, I said no official support, right? But however, there are a lot of online forums available. So if you got stuck somewhere, you can basically you can raise your concern in that forums. So you can definitely expect answer for that, and say, I said it supports web applications only. So for that, basically we have discussed the statistics. Out of 100 applications, say there are 70 to 75 applications are on web. Okay, that is where the demand for Selenium is increasing in this web application area. The demand for Qtip is decreasing. Okay. Now we'll get into this Selenium components. Shall I proceed? And I know when you look at this, say if you have see session 1, session 2, don't consider that session 1 means it has to be completed in only one class. It just I listed like this. Okay. There will be some sessions which are going to take more than one session. Say for example, if you take this, probably it may take 2 sessions. If you scroll down, here for Java, I just mentioned the 2 sessions only. This is purely Java. I just mentioned 2 sessions only, but it is going to take around 4 to 5 sessions. Minimum 4 sessions. Okay. So now we'll try to understand the Selenium components. We have been trying to understand, like just the introduction of, we have been having a automation introduction. Okay. We'll have a Selenium introduction now, like Selenium components. Before we get into Selenium, we'll have any questions if you we'll discuss if you have any questions.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.